j.schreck. Wow, we're out in it today. If you look up the hill, what you're gonna see is my ride. They just dropped me off in the middle of nowhere and they're heading up that direction. We're in the Agua Fria today, and what are we doing? We're looking for what I would consider to be the most epic petroglyph in not only Agua Fria, but probably the state of Arizona. And it's about 32, 33 degrees. I have my cold weather gear ready to pull out if I need it. I'm carrying it. But what we're looking for is the petroglyph they call Supernova. And I'm telling you what, I'm so excited to try to find this. It's unbelievable. This is probably the number one petroglyph, not only in Agua Fria, but in the state of Arizona. So what you might ask is, what makes this petroglyph so special? Well, this petroglyph was put there in reference to the supernova that happened in 1054 on July 4th. Now, for 23 days, ancients saw this event in the sky and dictated it down on a rock. Now, why is that so special? Why has that got me so excited? Well, the reason it's got me so excited is that they're using history. So there was an event that happened that was dictated down through centuries that the Chinese actually were the first to document that event. So it got documented in China, but it also got documented here on the Agua Fria in 1054 AD. That is absolutely unbelievable. So we've got an epic journey to try to find this. You know, this is a very well kept secret, and we have got some coordinates by pictures. So it's all basically a guess. I have no coordinates that's actual GPS. What I've got is coordinates that I believe are visuals of where I think this is located, but I'm not sure. We got a journey ahead of us. So this is going to be an unbelievable journey to try to find this single petroglyph that's on a rock by itself in 71,000 acres. So come along with me, because this is going to be unbelievable. Now, the first thing I want to show you is this. This ground, this soil is so difficult. It is so difficult to walk on, extremely difficult. So it's a hard hike. So the faster we find it, the better. Now, the good news is hopefully it'll warm up and we'll be able to find it. So I'm gonna work my way up this ridge and then back down into the canyon. But I believe it to be on top of this ridge, but you know, it's a crapshoot. But man, just a chance to get up here and to be able to seek this petroglyph is unbelievable. Just to have the opportunity to hike this area. I love the Agua Fria. It's probably one of my favorite places. So we're going to work our way up. John's going to work his way down. Poor James, he had to work again. Working gets in the way of so much cool exploring, but not eating, that's not good either. So I definitely get that. But we're going to work our way across this ridgeline. And I believe it to be across this groove here. But again, those are all estimations. So I'm not sure. So man, if you're ready for an epic adventure today, you're definitely going to get it. And I'm glad that you came along, because I find the whole theory of this petroglyph, it's really special to me. Because if you think about the ancients here and the amount of time that they would have watched with no light pollution, would have watched the sky, right? And really studied the sky. Now the event took place July 4th, 1054. Now it was visible. Okay, there we go. There's some nice glyphs right there. See those right there on this ridge? Now this is something that people haven't seen right there. So the great news is I know I've got people here on this side of the canyon. So that's the good news. So we've got them here. Now that gray rock down there is kind of the color of rock I'm looking for from the picture. Now I'm just going off pictures. So right now I'm thinking, okay, general vicinity wise, I feel pretty good that I'm in an area that possibly could be where I'm looking. I was guesstimating I was within 50 to 100 yards. I still don't see anything out here that would make me think that that's down there, but we're gonna walk that way. You know, most people won't take this hike, and I don't blame them, because today is a day that's gonna be really special. I plan to find this petroglyph, work that canyon out, find more petroglyphs, and then go to Baby Canyon 2 and actually drive to it, which is going to be an interesting journey, and I don't know what we're in for on that side. But, so how did I even know where to kind of look, whether I find it or not, but at least, you know, why am I sitting at this location? You know, places on the internet. You know, people has told me what they think. I've looked at pictures and then tried to line the pictures up from points of reference. Is it all a guess? I had a guy tell me, do you work for the FBI? Well, you know, if I did, I'd know who killed JFK, I believe. So that's what I do believe, because when I get into this stuff, I'm in. It ain't no jacking around. I mean, here's the real deal. Let's say I don't find it today, because we got a lot of work to do. Because it could be up here. It could be up on that shelf right there. It could be down here. You know, I don't know that. Now, I will walk over there and see if there's any glyphs, just to see if there's glyphs. Because this is an area you're going to see stuff that not a lot of people have seen on this side. They haven't went down this tower through this area. But what I do is, man, it's research on the internet. That's all it is. You have the same exact ability to find this stuff if you want to than I do. Now, I'm a little ADD with it, but the reality of it is, you know, and then once I get it in my head, whether it be the duck or man on fire or any of these other petroglyphs, which, or deer, the red deer, man, I don't stop. And I'm not going to quit until we find this. Now, doesn't mean I'm going to stay here all day today if I can't find it. So what would happen if I didn't find it, other than be disappointed and pissed off? I'd just do real research, look harder, you know, see what else I can find, see what I missed. You know, because this damn thing could be 20 yards from you out here in the middle of nowhere. And if you're scouring this by yourself, man, you're still talking about a hell of a lot of work to find this one stone out here that has this one petroglyph. So I could walk down here, miss it. It might have been on the top, and I missed it. So, you know, it's just, you gotta love to do this too, because this is one of the greatest games that you can ever play with yourself, is hunting this stuff down. It is so much fun. It really is. But everywhere there's clues, and it's fun to do. I actually love it. As frustrating as it can be, as difficult as the hiking is, man, this is fun. This is a real mystery game that you're playing in real life. And you're out here in the middle of the woods doing it. Now I'm going to walk up here a little bit. So why am I going to kind of go out of my range? Because I think I'm getting out of my range. I probably ought to check that top, because the thing is, you don't want to miss it by not going far enough. So I'm going to come over here, see if there's any petroglyphs on this ridge, more or less just to see if they were over here. I did read that there's a cliff wall and there's petroglyphs on that cliff wall, and then it sits behind it. So could it be up on that ridge? You know, I don't know. But I already am, you know, probably a mile from John. So, you know, you get out here pretty quick. Now I feel pretty comfortable that if there's hidden glyphs over here, there's no reason to go farther, because I have already found glyphs on that other wall. So here I see nothing. No glyphs. So when I say that, see, that's what's so crazy about this. I say no glyphs, and then I glance and all of a sudden I see this over here. It's like, okay, why was this here? There we are. It's not a lot, but there it is. And there's our famous circle. And what have I always said when I see a circle? That means this was a guess. This was a guess. It's over here. You know, so I'm gonna work my way back through this canyon, and I think it's down below. I really do. But again, am I guessing? You're damn right I'm guessing. So we're gonna drop down this hill a little bit and see what's up here. See what pets are over here. Take a quick visit before we roll on to the other area. But this is a fabulous place. Now,
go ahead.
I just wanted to check and see if you could even hear me.
I've been hearing you without the walkie-talkie.
Well, does that mean you're coming down the same chute that I've been in or not?
Well, I haven't heard you in the past 15 minutes, but when we started walking down into the canyon, we did hear you, but not lately.
Well, I'm thinking you might be in a different canyon, actually.
We found some petroglyphs, some old ones, nothing fancy, but they are here.
Well, I've run into them over here also. But it's not going to be as easy, just like I thought it's going to suck finding this thing, and it's going to suck.
Well, I guess we just keep going the way we're going for a little while and see what happens, huh?
Well, I'm just trying to figure out if you're even in the same canyon that I am. So, you know, it's even something as small as this, for example. You know, it goes to show you how crazy and how much difficulty there is finding this stuff. I just found some markings. They're not the best petroglyphs, but I just find some markings. Now, what I'm hoping is, look at that beautiful pool down there. Now, what I'm hoping is that there's something right there, is that I'm gonna run into them, that petroglyph I'm looking for, if my bearings are right, are gonna be in that field down there. So we'll just have to gingerly make our way through here, get around all that crap, and take a look, man. That's all we can do. I'll keep you on through here in case I fall down that. There's some old stuff right there. See that? Right there? It's been beat in, pecked in. I wish I had a different way. Look at this here. This is pretty neat. Now, it's these things here that you think that, you know, maybe you're going to see something that nobody's seen. So, there's something right there, but without a stretcher. But there's a deer right there. So, somebody was back in this little nook. Yeah, isn't that cool? I mean, they're in that little nook. And I still feel pretty comfortable that the direction I took was the right one.
I don't have my zoom. Can I get up near them to get a picture with a regular camera?
Yeah. Yeah, there's just layers of them. They're all over. They're not the greatest all over, but they're all over.
But I can get up to them without the zoom. Is that what you're telling me?
Yeah, you just got to climb through the creek. There's nice little circles right there. Nice archaic designs up there. We're going to crawl up that. Hope you guys like to rock climb. That was something in that wall. Here, all the way through here, there's stuff. You know, stuff through here. So, this is an incredible place. Very special place. But you know, could that be over there? Yeah, it could be over there. You know, the water wasn't in it, but look at that. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Look at that. And again, if the water wasn't in it, I don't know what kind of bees, but you can imagine the, that's crazy. That gets me going. I tell you, there's stuff all over. They're all over this area. Man. Whew. See if we can't walk over these rocks. Get down to that wall. Because those walls, you know, it's not a big one, but it definitely was something that they would have got into. And so let's take a look, and I'll, you know, there could be anything in here. Animals. I don't see any markings of any animals back here. But this was definitely a place that you could have got in and out of the rain. Looks like maybe something was marked here. See that red right here? Right there especially. You know, that definitely could have been something. And I tell you what. So, looky there. That's definitely been cut out right there. So that's definitely a marking. Isn't that incredible? So I'm gonna try to back out of here. Look at this. So look at these men right here. Okay. This is, okay. This is special, okay. So why is this so special to me? Whew. That's red. It definitely was marked in red. And you don't see, we haven't seen red over here on this side of the mesa. So, look at him right here. He probably lived there. So I'm gonna tell you that that was a special place, absolutely. And it also, if it was red, and I'm not, you know, it looked red. It looked like it had been worn out. There's stuff up here, stuff up there. I mean, there's markings all over this wall, which would also make me believe that not only was there a shaman here. Now, a little bit about shaman, from what I think I understand, is that shaman, you were born into a shaman family. So if you were a shaman and you had children, and I can't tell you specifically if it was male, but if you were born into that family, then you were automatically a shaman. So let's look at a little bit about the markings up here. And this is spectacular. And I've got one right here that is really something. Look at that. Hopefully you're getting that. And look at these up here. And there's the watchful eye up there. He was up there pecking away at this. And more here, more grinding. A large group of people were here. I mean, a large group of people were here. There was a large group. And then we climb over here. You know, the time to see whatever you want to see is right now. And so I just hope that I've deducted this correctly and that I've got it dialed in and we find, what do you see on the end? Right here, and they're all over here. And then hopefully that outcropping up there was the shaman's cave, because there definitely was an active shaman with an active imagination working in this area quite a bit. I mean, he was busy, and they were busy down here grinding and scraping and, you know, all kinds of different stuff. So it's an incredible place. Now, but it looked like it's got my packs, got me. Oh, shoot. Okay. So, we're going to scour up here, which I'm already going to tell you, I don't believe it's there. So, wow. That was a I don't see any rocks up here that look like what I'm looking for. Let's catch our breath, breathe, oxygen in, and then, but I can already tell you, this is a hell of a lot harder hike than I thought it was going to be already. I thought it was going to be a fairly easy down and out. It ain't easy out and down. I do see a rock over there. It looks like it does have glyphs. So we're going to. There's glyphs right here, but the rocks still don't look the same.
Jeff, you got a copy?
Tell me great news.
You hear me?
Yeah, what's the great news?
I got a supernova here.
Oh, yeah. yeah. So here we are, Pleiades, Capella, Orion,
Moon.
Supernova. See, I had a little help. Horizon. You heard that.
Horizon.
And then the horizon. See, everybody's helping. Isn't that funny?
We got all the answers.
Shit, we got it. You need some answers. I got some answers. You want some answers? I got some good answers. So, how beautiful is that? 1054. They saw that happen. But in 1054, July 4th, it started. But they were able actually to see that. Now, what's so important to me is that this is documented history of 1054 AD by ancients, but it also has been documented by the Chinese. So both cultures in different continents saw this action going on. So what it does to me also is it changes that, is a lot of this history that they're documenting, or is it what they're hoping for, or is it trade routes? It could be a lot of different things, but this is so critical. This is the number one petroglyph in the state of Arizona. So isn't that incredible?
Exactly.
See, we all know all this shit. So if you're thinking, we got answers. You know, we don't got no questions. We got answers.
Know. Maria knows. So
this is the number one petroglyph. So if you find this one, as much as I like Man on Fire or Duck, it doesn't matter. This is the number one petroglyph in the state of Arizona because it's the only one that I know of. Now, there are two others here that we have saw. Now, one, as John was even stating, he doesn't get enough credit because you can't see it. But it's just as equally spectacular, and I did shoot that, so I'll try to tie that in.
It is another supernova, no question. Yeah, I'm going to go back over there.
And it looks like a shield supernova. That backpack caused that. that, thank God I had long pants on. That one ain't healed yet. Got that one, banged a rock hard. So tomorrow, I'm going to be paying big time. But you know what, it ain't tomorrow. We dream only for today. And here I am in Agua Fria. Look at this. We saw the number one petroglyph in the state of Arizona, self-proclaimed, of course. But if you got a better one, tell me what it is and tell me why and tell me the history behind it that you know about. And the problem is going to be is you're not going to know the history because there's not going to be any. There's going to be a lot of assumption. I think this is the closest we've came to actually seeing what it was like of life, you know, on the Agua Fria. I tell you what a spectacular place, what a spectacular journey today. I'm glad you was able to come along. I'm glad John was here. I'm glad that Maria was here. We had a great time. Hell of a hike in, hell of a hike out. But you know what? This has been just a great experience. I'm glad you'd come along. And we're no worse for wear as usual, but what a great experience it was. And these power lines, I think they're buzzing me up a little bit. Good buzz is only a poor man's fault. J.schreck, Black Flag Expedition. Go explore something. I am kind of buzzing.